Today I'm going to be walking through the different accessories I got for my Tesla Model Y before I took delivery so I could install them on day one. I'll put some timestamps down below in case you want to skip around, but the accessories I got are smartphone suction mount for videos, Mac glass screen protector, wireless charging mount, console organizer, center console cover, USB for dash cam, and this wheel cap cover kit. And here's my reaction when a seagull left me a gift on the brand new car.
Dylan, why are you sad?
Bird just pooped on my car.
So the first thing that I'm actually going to talk about is this clamp. If you're a content creator or have a smartphone and want to also make videos with your Tesla, because of this awesome panoramic roof, all you need is the suction cup mount for your phone to get stabilized rolling footage using your smartphone. This one in particular has a little bit of a cheap build in the plastic, but right now it seems pretty sturdy working, and the adjustable arm seems pretty tight, although I do worry about the cheapness of the plastic. But I'll be using this to actually help me film a lot of this video, and if you want to check it out, link in the description down below. I'm opting for a matte glass screen protector. I want matte to help diminish some of the glare that might be coming in. But I also like glass because I like the feel of glass. I think plastic screen protectors feel kind of cheap, and a matte glass screen protector is a great medium. Oh, it looks so clean. Because we're doing this immediately, maybe we don't even need a cleaning cloth, although I'm sure it's a little staticky. I'm getting some dust, but I think that's a bit inevitable. I'm gonna pull this out of the sheath. All right, let's actually, I've never tried screen cleaning mode, so display, screen clean mode. Really just trying to get rid of bubbles. Screen protector looks pretty good. All right. So now we have this frosted glass. I will say that there is still, like, when there's direct sunlight on this side, I don't know if you can see that in the camera, there is still a decent amount of glare. So I would say actually from just typical position, I do see a little bit of glare still on the side, but otherwise it was a good fit. The installation was about what I expected, and it feels nice and looks good. I also have this 128 gig hard drive. I'm actually not sure if I have to format this before doing this. Probably should have looked at that before. But what this is primarily gonna be used for is dash cam footage. Now, I can also do Sentry mode, but this car is gonna be parked primarily inside of a garage, so I can activate Sentry mode when I maybe park somewhere where I feel like it might be necessary. But typically, I think this will do pretty well for dash cam footage. So dash cam footage actually overwrites itself automatically, and you can also save honking, like save a clip when you honk, so you don't have to worry about, you know, manually clearing stuff out. Sentry mode, you do have to manually worry about that. To get rid of this phone here, raise up the wireless charger, and access to this USB drive. So now that that's in, how do I... All right, so format USB drive. Yes, format. Great. So now, if you look at this top right area, the dash cam is actually recording. So if you click over and then hit save footage, it'll save the footage. I also want, let's see, the controls where I have safety security, save clips on honk. I think that's pretty cool. And then, so now if we go up here, we can hit launch viewer. And I don't know how long this has been running, but oh, there we go. So I actually didn't realize that the car to the left of us pulled out a few seconds ago, but there you can see it on the rear cam. Here you can see it on the right cam. And then on the front, here's where we are. So these hubs actually come off, and let me just try to... I was honestly a bit nervous to do that because they're pretty tight on there. Okay, so I took this off. I'm gonna keep that there. And this wheel is just left underneath. There's a sticker there still. And what I got were these nut caps and also cover caps for here. I got black. I actually like the idea of the contrast. And so I'm gonna take these out of these sleeves here, remove this peel. I
I'm not gonna do that for all the wheels because I do actually think I still want the hubcaps for right now, especially because I think I'm gonna be doing some long distance driving in the future. But this looks really great. Taking off the wheel caps is actually gonna reduce your range around 4%, sometimes more in cases. So while I love the way this looks, I am gonna primarily use the typical aero caps. I'd love to have the option of just being able to rock the wheels as they are.
So this one's pretty simple and self-explanatory. This is the center console organizer. I got this from a company called Top Fit, and they sent this out. And what this should do is make this tray area a little bit organized. These sort of soft rubber pads for each of these locations. So it should fit like this. And I believe this goes in like this. Now let me try. So I have to unplug that. There we go. And then boom. So now this center console has different compartments. You could have maybe coins, spare change for parking. Actually, I think these are for coins. If you have a card you need to put in, sunglasses, whatever. And so this is just a really nice and easy way to organize your console. So after playing around with it for a bit, I do have it working. I would say the fit was a bit difficult, and it does make this a bit less deep. So your two options here, if you do go with this console, you have organization and you make it more shallow. So maybe if you put stuff, you don't have to, you know, reach in, dig as deep for it. But it does require a pretty tight fit. Also reduces the total volume that you have for storage. So while you're organizing, you're reducing volume.
But you can also put stuff underneath it.
And you could also put stuff underneath it, which might be really good if you have something that's more secure, right? More sensitive. You could put it under that and it'd be really hard to get to. Overall, I think if you're dissatisfied with the center console storage options, this could be something that you look for, but just know based on your own personal preference and layout what you're looking for, and you can make a decision based on that. So one thing that you may have already noticed is just from touching the center console, this piano black is really glossy and gets a lot of smudges and smears and fingerprints on it. I'm the type of person who always puts a screen protector or a phone case on immediately once I get it. Obviously you can see even with this screen, that's what I did here. So what this is a center console cover. Now this is a matte black version, which would theoretically not get as many smudges or fingerprints. I'm actually iffy on this. I have this because I wanted to test out a different option for a center console cover. Now, I actually kind of like the glossy look, but it's just so hard to maintain. And I'm just, once again, so scared that it's gonna get scratched. So this isn't a wrap. This is actually a piece of hard plastic and it adheres directly to the console. So it's not like a skin where you have to line it up and peel it correctly and really be precise with it. And it should also serve as pretty good protection against dings and scratches and whatnot because it's actually, like, you know, significant. It's solid. So we'll give it a try and see what it looks like. And I've also been promised that this is easy remove adhesive. If I have to get like glue gun because of this, I would be pretty sad. First of all, I wanna make sure that this is cleaned off and wiped. Because of the way that these work magnetically, it is actually kind of difficult to wipe these down clean, but I think I've got that. And I can just place this as precisely as I'm able to here. How's that look? Good?
Mm-hmm.
I think it looks pretty good. All right, just press it in place and then make sure that it's still, all right. Looking at actually this piece in here, I think it looks pretty good. As someone who opened the packaging and wasn't super impressed by the actual bits here, seeing it on the console, it actually does look pretty good. It actually matches like the size.
Yeah, they did a really good job matching. Yeah.
So just visually, it's pretty good.
This goes back deceptively far. Actually, let me pull this back. Okay, line it up.
So now in case we bring our pet rats in here and they crawl around on the center console, they can't scratch it up.
Yeah, they can scratch anything else though.
That's why they stay in their cage if they go on road trips with us.
And this is what it looks like fully put on. It actually looks pretty good.
But most importantly, it's protecting the center console from scratches, scrapes, and fingerprints. Look, I can rub my fingers all over it and still looks pretty clean. Sweet.
What we have here is actually a phone mount. And so one thing that I'm actually a bit curious about, can I keep using the wireless chargers in that pad and also use this? So right now there's one USB Type-C port there and then one USB Type-A port in the console. This requires a USB cable and connection to work, so we're gonna have to test that out.
Dylan, why do you need this if you have that?
One, you can have navigation on your phone and also pull up the repeating cameras and the rear cameras. Two, people who might be driving Uber or Lyft or just prefer something like Waze and don't feel like using the pretty unreliable web options for things like Waze, might still want to have their phone up here. In addition, there's a sunglasses holder. What I have to do here is actually go into the car, quick controls, and then move the steering wheel all the way out. So I don't want to put this on my profile, but it's all the way out and down. So included with this is a USB type A to USB type C. And then there's also this car jack charger. And I guess you could run this through so you're not using one of those USB ports there that can do USB Type-C for the charger and data. Let me try it out though. I'm curious if that works.
Whoa, it goes on there?
Yeah, so I'm sliding this over.
Where the heck does the sunglass holder go?
It goes in the back here.
Oh.
I wish the tolerances were a little bit better on this. As you can see, it sort of extrudes out here. And it's kind of clicky. I'm not confident in my ability to, you know, get this off very easily. So we're gonna have to see how that looks. But generally it looks pretty clean. There's some ridges and grooves here. I don't know how much of this type of stuff might bother people. So what I'm finding is that if you were already using a USB device, a USB for something like dash cam here, you would need a splitter to cleanly run this cable through along the other side and have this sort of invisible look. The included car charger here, if you were to use it like this, which is currently my preferred way of doing it because I don't want to take up any of the ports, I think you would have to have this cable out here, which I'm not a huge fan of. So for the purpose of this, I'm going to test it out and show how it works, but I actually might not run with this until I get a USB splitter up front because I don't want to leave this cable out. And I also don't want to not be able to have dash cam footage. I do think this is a super cool design where if you take a phone, right, it wirelessly charges and you just touch the side here and it actually mechanically closes. And the phone is charging and you could hide this wire like this. I don't know why, there's just something so satisfying about that. So those were the Tesla accessories that I bought day one for my Model Y. Let me know if you have any suggestions, feedback, anything that you think I should have checked out or should get moving forward. I'll link everything that I talked about in the description down below. Big shout out to TopFit for sending out some of those accessories that I checked out from their website. To the rest of you, thanks for watching and happy Halloween. I guess you'd be watching this after Halloween, but look, they're Halloween people. See, I told you. Thanks for watching.